So today let's test some more lithium-ion batteries, because there is just never enough of lithium-ion batteries, of course. I've got three more lithium-ion batteries from eBay, and I'm going to weigh it, I'm going to charge it and discharge it and analyze it using my DIY battery analyzer to measure the capacity of it. So the first one is a Trustfire battery, even though I don't trust any fire. It's IMR18650, it says 40 amps. That's quite a current, I'm not sure about it. 3.7 volts, 2500 milliamp hours and 9.25 watt hours. So this one actually says the capacity of it in milliamp hours, but also the energy in it in watt hours. Which is nice. Lithium ion rechargeable battery, the polarity marking, and there is some barcode on it. And so let's unwrap it. And as you can see, it's a flat top battery. Not a button top. So let's unwrap it. There is another barcode on it with some other markings. Do not disassemble, dispose in fire, heat or short circuit. Do not insert the batteries with the plus and minus reversed. Do not mix fresh batteries with used batteries. Do not submerge the battery in water. Made in China. So this one seems nice. The capacity is definitely passable, 2500 milliamp hours is definitely passable in 18650 size. It was $6, so it was bloody expensive actually, compared to the others. The next one is Castnu, such a strange name. It says 3000 milliamp hours, which is not impassable, but it's quite a high capacity, which you normally see just in expensive batteries, just in the good brands. 18650 lithium-ion rechargeable battery, Castnu, warning, the voltage of full charge and cutoff discharge is 4.2 volts and 2.7 volts. Don't heat, incinerate or reverse polarity. Rechargeable battery with NK, red discharging protection circuit, low discharge rate, no memory effect. Low recurring operation cost, short circuit and overcurrent protection, sheaf life around 10 years, and environmental friendly, and of course made in China. So this is the second one for $2.70 including shipping, and I'm a little bit more suspicious about this one. And the last one is Security ING, and I have to say that I have ordered 3000 milliamp hour version, but they sent me just 1800 milliamp hour one. It says Security ING 18650, 1800 milliamp hours, 3.7 volts, and some text in Chinese, but I'm not so good at Chinese yet, so I can recognize just 2.75 volts. This is probably the cutoff voltage. And some other text. In English, do not dispose in fire or heat, do not puncture, damage and disassemble, do not mix fresh batteries with used batteries, rechargeable battery with red discharging protection circuit. So this one looks cheapish and it also is cheap, but this capacity is not a problem nowadays, so it could be possible. It was for $2.40 including shipping, and this one is a button top, just like this one. And this one is also in some kind of wrap, so let's unwrap it. Those two are button tops. Now let's try to weigh it, because the weight of it can easily reveal the fake batteries, because the fake ones are sometimes up to 50% lighter. So the first one is about 45.5 grams. Which is quite nice. And this one is just 35.6. This one is much lighter, despite it says higher capacity, which is quite suspicious. And the last one is 36.7. So it's a lower capacity, but still it's quite light. And just for comparison, this is the battery I have already measured, and it's a flat top and it's about 2300 milliamp hours, and it weighs 47 grams, it's quite heavy. Some other battery. Some battery made in Canada. A good battery probably. 46 grams, also quite heavy. Another battery, almost 2000 milliamp hours. 44 grams, also relatively heavy. And now some fake batteries, 9900 milliamp hours. This is just ridiculous, that's impossible. It's absolutely impossible in this size of a battery. And it weighs just 24 grams. Another fake battery, 5000 milliamp hours, also absolutely impossible. And again, 24 grams. This one says 4500 milliamp hours, also impossible. Again, 24 grams. And the last one. And this one is the winner of the highest ever fake capacity, 12,000 milliamp hours. It's really not 1200, it's 12,000. Absolutely crazy, absolutely ridiculous and impossible. And it's 25 grams. And I have to say that all those fake batteries are actually just 500 milliamp hours. Just 500 milliamp hours. No matter what it says. And it's quite a difference in weight. This fake one is only 24 grams and this real one is 47, which is almost twice the weight. Here you can see a low capacity battery, which is close to its rated value and it's still 36 grams. So if you see a battery which is just 24 grams, it's definitely fake. Now, before charging it, let's measure the initial voltage it came at, because there is a certain voltage which is perfect for lithium-ion battery storage. And as far as I know, it's 3.82 volts. And the battery should be charged to this voltage for a long storage. And it should arrive to the customers at this voltage. So let's check it. The first one is 3.87, which is quite close to it, so it's okay. This one is 3.76, which is also quite close. That's nice. And the last one is 3.35. That's bad. That's a bad voltage for storage. The farther the voltage is from this, the faster it deteriorates, the faster it loses its capacity. So this one being stored at such a low voltage, it's gonna lose its capacity very fast. At this voltage it's almost flat, and this is the voltage with no load. When loaded it's even lower. So this one is more or less flat. Not good for storage. But a storage at a full charge at 4.2 volts is also quite bad for it. It should be 3.82 volts, which is about halfway. So let's charge it, starting with this one. Now let's discharge it using my DIY battery analyzer. Here's the actual voltage. Now let's discharge it at half an amp, down to 3 volts. So let's start. It's discharging. Here is the energy in watt hours, counting up. And the capacity in amp hours, also counting up. So let's leave it discharging until it finishes. So the battery is flat and it came out as 2373 milliamp hours, which is quite close to the nominal 2500. About plus minus 10% difference is okay, it can be just different measuring conditions. And the energy is 8.68 watt hours, which is also quite close. And now the second one. Is it gonna be 3000? I'm quite suspicious. Just 921 milliamp hours. That's quite disappointing. And today I'm recording from a dog location instead of a cat location, so here's my dog. And the last one. And it's only 854. That's quite bad. So that's about the entire test, and as you can see, this one is nice, but those two are just rubbish. The capacity is about 30% of what it should be. So I asked for a refund. Let's see what's gonna happen. So this is Diet Gone Wild, and see you in my next videos. And thanks to all of my patrons on Patreon. I really appreciate your support. And it actually fits in my vintage flashlight. Just accidentally, because this one was made long before those lithium-ion batteries existed.